This is it.
Look for speed.
Going into my third Olympics, I'm getting a lot of questions about, oh, what's it going to mean to you to, you know, potentially win your third gold medal, or how much pressure do you feel to win again? And the reality for me is I'm still in a state in my career where I'm trying to find what the limits are. It's not necessarily about comparing myself to my peers and my competitors. It's more about what can I do with the body I was given and how far can I take this. So I've been having a lot of fun trying to innovate and doing things differently than I have in the past. Thing for me in my career now is that I don't have anything left that I need to prove. Whether we're talking about proving to other people or proving even to myself, even if I had to quit skiing tomorrow competitively, I wouldn't feel like I was dissatisfied. I've had an amazing career to this point. And now looking forward, I really am just trying to sort of embrace the opportunity that I've been given. I could have quit after the last Olympics if I wanted to, but I still had that hunger, I still had that fire to go out there and see what else I can do on skis. And that fire is not going to last forever in the game of halfpipe skiing, but I'm going to be a lifelong skier. I'm always looking for some new adventure, some new obstacle to overcome, some new task to learn how to do, some thing that I'm not good at that I can increase my skill level at. And I'm just taking it one day at a time and trying to see where I can take skiing. I think for me, my mental and spiritual health kind of go hand in hand. And when one is not right, then the other one's not usually right. So it's really important during crazy times of your life, like we're about to have, just to remain grounded. For me, I feel like my faith is a big part of what grounds me. Constantly reading the good word, spending time in prayer and meditation, having that solitude away from all the distractions and all the noise is really huge. So it's important to take time and have solitude and remind yourself that why you're out there and that we're out there to enjoy the bodies that we've been given and do the best we absolutely can. But there are things that are outside our control too. And one thing that I constantly reflect on this topic is the fact that both of the gold medals I've already won seem unreal to me. I don't think of them as like, I don't look back on those days and like hype myself up and say, yeah, I just went out there and crushed it and that's mine, I earned it. I really have this overwhelming sense of gratitude that it actually happened that way, and I'm kind of surprised. So I think that kind of helps me not to feel pressured when I look at it that way. Like I'm already so fortunate to have won two of these things. And I think one of the most vital things for any athlete is to surround yourself with people who care about who you are, not what you do. And it's been kind of vital for me because I've been able to weed out the people and the influences who just want to take from me and don't want to give anything back. And most of the close friendships that I have now are all people who love me for who I am, not what I've done on a pair of skis. So that's a huge part of mental health. And so I'm going to spend as much time as I can with the family and just enjoy the ride.